And that's how you build optimal core stability.
What's up, my name is Dr. Alex Straley. If you're looking to decrease daily aches and pains or improve athletic performance, you've come to the right place. Go ahead and subscribe and hit that notification bell so you know each time a new video is uploaded. Let's get right on into this. What is the McGill Big Three? The McGill Big Three is an abdominal curl up, side bridge, or side plank. And let's go ahead and dive right into all three of them. The first one we're gonna look at is a curl up, but it's not actually really a curl up at all. So for the starting position, you're gonna lay on the ground, have your hands underneath your back, one leg straight and one leg bent. The reason we do one leg straight and one bent is to keep the spine in a neutral position. If you flex both legs, that decreases the curvature in your spine. And if you leave both legs straight while doing the exercise, it increases the forces to the spine. So one leg straight, one leg bent. What you're gonna do is flex your T-spine or your mid-back. Think of your head, your neck, and your torso as one unit. I drew these lines in for better visualization of what's going on. Our head and our neck are staying stable and we're flexing just from the middle thoracic spine. This is not a big movement. We're looking for maybe an inch. I heard Dr. McGill once say, if you put a scale underneath your head, you want it just enough for it to say zero. He says that the biggest mistake you can make with this exercise is lifting your body too far. If you are having neck pain while doing this, try to jam your tongue to the top of your mouth. This is going to activate the digastric. These are a couple of neck muscles which will help stabilize your neck and hopefully decrease your pain. So there's ways to progress all these exercises. For this first one, you can lift up your elbows but not your shoulders. Leave those where they are. Add just the elbows to the equation. So for this next one, try to pre-brace your core. Now don't breathe in a bunch of air, and as you move up, think about contracting into that brace. McGill says this is the secret to this exercise, is contracting against the brace. The next progression is putting your hands by your head but not underneath your head. Take it up one more step and try to breathe through the entire exercise. Breathing while we're bracing can be difficult, but it's also a very important skill to master. For the curl up, I like to do about 10 seconds at a time, maybe 3 to 5 sets, but that's definitely going to depend on your ability to do the exercise. The second exercise is a side bridge or a side plank. So the lowest level of this exercise is having your opposite hand on your shoulder, helping to stabilize that shoulder, as well as having your knees bent on the ground. You can take it up a step by leaving your knees on the ground, but no longer stabilizing your shoulder and placing that arm on your torso. The third progression is straighten your knees so now they're no longer touching the ground and it's just your elbow and your feet. Now take notice of the feet here. They're not stacked on top of one another. Your top foot is actually placed in front of the bottom foot. And the reason for this, I believe, is so you can do this next progression where you're rolling over. You're going from a side plank to a normal plank to the other side plank. Now with this rolling progression, it's super important to keep your torso stabilized. It should look like this where your torso and your pelvis are one unit. However, the compensation we'll see is that there's a disassociation between the torso and the pelvis and one goes before the other. As McGill says, be disciplined so your pelvis does not leave the rib cage. Now, according to his book, this exercise should be done for more than 10 seconds at a time. Now, this one I'll usually do for 10 to 15 seconds and roll back and forth about 3 times on each side. Again, it all depends on your level and how good you are at the exercise. Now, the third exercise here is a bird dog. Now, personally, I think the abdominal curl up is the hardest one for people to grasp, but I think the bird dog is the hardest one for people to perform correctly. So this challenges the thoracic and the lumbar spinal erectors. For those people who find their back rounding while they're deadlifting, this is gonna be extremely difficult, but extremely important for them to practice. You wanna move your opposite arm and leg out, but not past horizontal. This is one mistake a lot of people make, is they go too far. You wanna think about elongating your body and pushing your hand and your heel away from you. You should have a neutral spine and good bracing throughout the whole movement. Now to start this, you can do just the arm or the leg. The second step would be doing opposite arm and leg at the same time. One of the key things to this movement is really think about driving your heel back and punching your fist forward. To advance this movement, you can apply a sweep to it. So what that means is in between movements, you're sweeping your arm and leg back, but they're not touching the ground, and then you're pushing them back out. Another way to advance this is to make it even more dynamic. Once you push your arm and your leg out, you can draw shapes or letters to add more movement to it. This is one unlike the other two that you should not do for a long time. He only recommends 6 to 8 seconds. Now, one really good way to see if you're doing this right is place a foam roller, a shoe, or a water bottle on your low back. Now, as you're doing this motion, that item should stay right where it is. And if it falls off, you know that you lost your neutral spine. If you've had low back pain and stabilization exercise helped you, or if you're just trying to build a stable core, these three exercises are something you could and should do every single day. You can knock them out in a matter of minutes, but they're gonna have huge implications for your core stability. I hope you enjoyed. If you missed any other part of the core series, go ahead and check out that playlist here.